Okay, so today we're going to do something for the young members of our audience. We're going to talk a little bit at the second and third grade level about a very nice observation about square numbers and adding odd numbers. So before you learn how to multiply numbers, one of the things you want to be able to do is you want to be able to think about multiplication as computing areas of squares and rectangles. There are lots of ways about thinking about multiplication. This is one way. And so we want to think about areas of squares to begin with. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a 1x1 square. So that's 1 unit by 1 unit. And so we have 1 times 1 is equal to 1. And the next thing I want to do is to add 3 to that 1x1 square. And the 3 that I'm going to add aren't going to be 3 squares in a line. They're going to be 3 squares in this shape here. So if I take 1 plus 3, I get 4, which is the same thing as 2 times 2. And the next thing I want to do to that is I want to add 5 to that. So I'm going to think about 5 as being 2 times 2 plus 1. So 1 plus 3 plus 5 is the same thing as 4 plus 5 is the same thing as 9. And so this is my 5 on the outside plus the square 4 area. And so that's going to be the same thing as 3 times 3. And let's continue this. We're going to look at 7. 7 is an odd number, so it's going to be 1 more than an even number. And an even number would be 2 times a number. So it's 1 more than 2 times 3. So we're going to take 2 bits of size 3 and add on 1. So this L shape has 7 squares in it. And then if I add on what I had before, I get 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 is equal to 9 plus 7, so that's equal to 16. And that's the same thing as 4 times 4. So this is 4 units this way and 4 units this way. Okay, let's add on one more odd number. So 9 is an odd number, and as an odd number, it's 1 more than an even number. So it's 1 more than 2 times 4. So it's 1 more than 8. 9 is 1 more than 8. So we want to take 2 times 4. So here's 1 times 4. And then 2 times 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We add one more on there. And then, so that's our 9 piece. And then from what we just did, we have that 7 plus 5 plus 3 plus 1 was equal to 16. So here we get 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 is equal to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 by 5, so that's 25, and that's 5 times 5. Now, the general statement is that if you keep adding odd numbers together and you add successive odd numbers together, then you'll always get a perfect square. And so the idea is that if we say 1 is the zeroth odd number, and 3 is the first odd number, and 5 is the second odd number. We have to start counting in that peculiar way, and you'll see why. And 7th is the third odd number. Then, if you keep counting, the nth odd number will be of the form 1 more than 2 times n. So the nth odd number is 2 times n plus 1. And if we add 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7, and just keep adding them all together until we get to 2 times n plus 1, then that's going to be a perfect square. And what perfect square is it going to be? Well, it's going to be n plus 1 quantity squared. Now let's go over here and say a little bit more about that. Another way of saying that is if you take the difference of consecutive squares, you get an odd number. So let's see what we mean by that. So we're going to take 25 times 25. 25 times 25 is 625. And if we take 24 times 24, that's going to be 576. So if we take 25 times 25 minus 24 times 24, then we'll get 49. And 49 is 1 more than 2 times 24. Continuing, let's look at 24 times 24. Remember, that's 576. And 23 times 23 is 529. And if we subtract 23 times 23 from 24 times 24, then we get 47. So 16 minus 9 is 7, so we borrow a 1 from the 7. 6 minus 2 is 4, so we get 49. And 47 is 1 more than 2 times 23. Let's continue. If we take 23 times 23, that would be 529. 22 times 22 is going to be equal to 484. When we subtract, we get 23 times 23 minus 22 times 22 will be equal to, let's see, we get a 5 here. We borrow 1 from the 5, we have 12 minus 8, so we get 45. So we have 45, 47, and the number before was 49. 45 is 1 more than 2 times 22. So 1 more than 44. And this pattern always continues. So the difference of consecutive squares is an odd number, and the odd number it is 1 more than twice the smaller number.